Vijila, Sathyananth.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. I wish to remember and extend my gratitude to my mentor, my beloved leader, Purachi Thalavi Amma, the champion of social justice. And I stand before you to speak on this very important bill brought by the Union Government in the light of the recent court rulings and unrest issues all over the country. Sir, Chairman, sir, the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhiji, has said, untouchability is sin, and my fight against untouchability is a fight against impure inhumanity. Had he been alive today, he would have condemned the lynching and mobocracy with such striker tone and tenure. I am glad that our Honorable Prime Minister and his team has took a historical decision that important changes will be made in the SC/ST Prevention of Atrocities Act 1989 to restore the status as it is prior to the decision of Supreme Court dated 23-2018. Sir, the government restored the Bill 1989 to its original form. The law was first enacted in 1989 and strengthened in 2015 when caste slurs were also brought under this ambit. But the conviction rate under the Act remains low, just 15% in 2016, according to the National Crimes Bureau. And on the other side, there is a widespread concern over misuse of the provisions of this Act. Sir, against innocent persons, this is also is happening. As per the Supreme Court, it's being used, the Supreme Court of India has already said the SC/ST Act has become an instrument of blackmail and is being used for vengeance and to satisfy vested interest. But crimes against SC/ST are of various forms, like social boycott. Caste Panchayat often acts as an arena for perpetuating atrocities against Dalits by troubling and discriminating them from the society. And Baba Sahib Ambedkar has recognized the atrocities meting out to Dalits in the form of social boycott. We need a comprehensive anti-discrimination law in lines of civil rights entitlements, like US, UK. Law Commission drafted the prohibition of unlawful assembly, interference with the freedom of matrimonial alliances Bill 2011 that has sought to declare caste panchayats unlawful. And the next one is the honor killing. In the society like India, where caste structures are still dominant in the form of endogamy, honor killings are prevalent all along in a wide scale. And Dalits are almost always at the receiving end of the violence. The cow vigilantism. The term cow vigilantism is used to describe the lawlessness happening under the name of cow protection. Dalits, Muslims are at the receiving end of the vigilantism. But since the Dalits are concentrated in the occupation of leather making from the heights of cow, they are invariably targeted by the vigilantes. Cow vigilantism has increased in the last years and it has to be curtailed. Discrimination in universities and colleges, and especially the tribal people, caste clashes, these are to be the, now I, because Vijilaji, my time is running out,
Vijilaji,
I'm just
you come to
coming
main
to the final
point.
Points. Around 70% of the scheduled caste and 85% of the scheduled tribes are living in Tamil Nadu. All atrocities against women belonging to the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe are tried by the special courts for women, especially by the earnest efforts of our Honorable Amma. The special Mahila courts, women judges, women public prosecutors, preferably belonging to the scheduled caste, should be all over the country. All women police stations in Tamil Nadu. first of its kind in the world.
Right.
Or the brainchild of Amma. All these women's police stations gives assistance and redressal to the grievances of women, especially the SCST community. And I would appeal unwillingness to file a first information report under this caste.
Right.
Under this act comes from caste bias. Policemen are still reluctant to file cases against fellow caste members
because
of the severity of penalties imposed in the act. Most offences are non-bailable and carry minimum punishments of 5 years imprisonment. Out of the several thousands of prevention of atrocities cases pending before the law, only the limited are brought to the trial.
Please conclude. Delay,
yes, I wanted by the final words, educate, agitate and organize. Have faith in yourself. For ours is the battle, not for wealth, not for power. It is the battle for freedom. It is the battle of reclamation of human personality. This is the statement of Baba Sahib Ambedkar among the Dalit community and its supporters and sympathizers.
Thank you, Vijila ji. Now we go to Abhir Ranjan Vishwas.
No,
I don't need more time, please. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Abhir Ranjan Vishwas.